I have been always fascinated with infographics and story-based visuals. A pictograph is a great example of this, but apart from this, there is a chart in Excel about which most of us are not aware of. That's called People Graph. If you haven't used Excel's People Graph add-in yet, you will like it. If you need to show a quantity of people or a handful of other objects for any reason. In a people graph, instead of column, bar or a line, we have icons to present the data, and it looks nice and professional. It's part of an update of Excel 2016 for both Windows and Mac. My name is Andreas, and in this lesson we will learn how to use Excel's people graph to create an interactive, quick, easy infographic using form controls and Vlookup function. I will use Excel 2019 to make it. So let's get started. In this worksheet, I have a number of employees from various age groups in a company. Some of them work part-time and the rest work full-time. We will use this data to create a people graph. The first step is to enable this feature. Go to Insert tab, and from Add-in section, click on this green button. It will insert a people graph with dummy data. Now, your next step is to connect data with the chart. Click on Data icon on the upper right corner of the graph, change the title of the graph, and then click on Select your data button. Highlight the employees that work part-time, from A2 to B6 cell. Nice! There are some customization options which can do after that. There are three predefined chart types which we can use. Click on the Setting button and select a type which you want. I'll choose this one. We can also use different themes for our chart. There are 7 predefined themes which we can use. Click on the Setting button and select a type which you want. We can't use a single shape for all types of data. So that's why there are 12 different shapes from which we can select. Click on the Setting button and select the shape which you want. Of course, when you update any value in the source data, the people graph is automatically updated. If you want to use it further in PowerPoint, send it in an email, upload to the web, etc., you can convert it as an image and save it from this arrow. Also, you can click the Copy button from Home tab, go to an empty sheet, and from Paste options, select this one, Paste as Picture. Now here is the interesting part of our video tutorial. I want to convert this people graph into a chart in which we can use data in a dynamic way. First of all, we want to insert 2 option buttons from Developer tab and Form Controls. Here is the first option button. And here is the second. After that, we want to connect each of these option buttons to a cell. In my case, I will connect them with cell A8. How do we do that? Right-click on the first button, Format Control, Control Tab, click the upper arrow from Cell Link and select A8 cell. Okay, let's do the same with the second button. So, if I check the first button, the A8 cell changes to number 1. If I check the second, the value changes to number 2. Great! The next step is to insert a VLOOKUP formula in cell B9. that will change when I press option button 1 or 2. Let's start typing. Equal VLOOKUP parentheses. The lookup value is the age group A9. The table array is from A2 to C6. The column index number is A8 in absolute reference plus 1. So if the value of A8 is 1, it will appear the second column, which is B, part-time. And if the value of A8 is 2, it will appear the third column, which is C, full-time. We want the exact match, so I will type 0, close parenthesis, and enter. In its simplest form, the VLOOKUP function says equal VLOOKUP, what you want to look up, where you want to look for it, the column number in the range containing the value to return, and return an approximate or exact match, indicated as 1 true or 0 false. We could use the new XLOOKUP function, an improved version of VLOOKUP that works in any direction and returns exact matches by default, making it easier and more convenient to use than its predecessor. But I will do a separate video tutorial for XLOOKUP later. Also, if you still need more help about VLOOKUP, check out my video tutorial for VLOOKUP function. Copy the formula all the way down, and at this point we have a dynamic table where we can get data by using option buttons. The last step is to connect the people graph with the new data. So highlight it, click the data icon, change the title, click on the green button, select your data, highlight the data from A9 to B13, and click on create, test it, and our dynamic people graph is ready. If you want, you can do some formatting, like removing grid lines, renaming the option buttons, and grouping them. Infographics are superb in presenting data in a vivid way, and I believe that creating a people graph in Excel is really fun. You can also use it in your dashboards and templates to give them an awesome look and for an effective way to make others understand data. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I want to thank you for watching it.